comparatively clear face of Jake Butler is contrasted by the...
No headbutting, no groins, no aggressive fans, aggressive fight, okay, catch drops, come up.
He's got his hands kind of low, but he's using that reach advantage and he's crouching over. And it looks like Ali is a little pensive, trying to set that right hand up.
Oh, left hand from Jake Butler just scuffed the nose of the Egyptian.
Jake's got to be careful. You see when he throws that jab, I notice right away he brings it to his hip after he brings it back to his face. And that's how you're going to get caught with that overhand right.
Oh, left hand. And he just ducked low down. Boy, he took an uppercut there, Jake Butler. Some big bombs being thrown here.
Well, there's not going to be any surprises as far as the game plan that wants to be executed by Jake Butler or by Muhammad Ali. Ali knows that Jake has a high-level wrestling pedigree, and he's going to want to take him down and exploit the biggest difference in his arsenal, is that grappling game. But man, he got stuffed twice and then ate a couple of shots on the way out.
Got quick hands, the Egyptian.
Does. You know, the problem is that Jake hasn't really set up his hands enough for Ali to really respect that takedown. It's hard. I mean, you know, they teach you in wrestling that you really shouldn't shoot unless you can touch your opponent's shoulder, and Jake's taking shots from a distance. Nice takedown.
What a swinging left that was that Jake ducked underneath and then got himself in the guillotine. But wow, the speed.
That's a deep guillotine, but Jake's has his left arm in, and this is really all Jake's world here. He's going to start to work slowly to get that arm out. Ali would probably be better served to let go of Jake's head and use that far arm to try to turn in and recompose or push Jake off. Because all he's really doing, holding Jake's head down with one arm there, is delaying the inevitable, which is that Jake's going to get his head out.
Well, as you say, this is where Butler wants the fight to be.
Well, Ali's doing a good job of recomposing guard here. He's pushing on Jake's hip, using his form like he should be. He's going to try to snake that right knee through and either compose full guard, or he might start to look for some sweeps from here. And one of the first things they teach you in jiu-jitsu is if you're on your back, you want to try to get to your side. It's always a better spot than being flat on your back. And Jake's going to start just chopping away like wood, using those short elbows, using his right hand to pull Ali's face into those elbows, just adding insult to injury.
No duck back.
Jake's going to start to look, use that right hand to push down on the thigh at some point and want to pass.
Action!
Either into cross side or right into mount. See right there, he's got that hand. He's going to start pushing down and squeezing his knee out.
No duck back.
Getting yelled at by Yuji. Keeps a tight ship, Yuji Shimada.
God, Yuji's refed, I think, 4,600,037 MMA fights, dating back from when Jesus is at the Last Supper.
Doesn't look that old, does he? But anyway.
No, he doesn't age.
Wow.
He's been in there with some champs.
And
Jake Butler looking to get back into the champ status here in contender. Keeping good pressure on Ali. And you can't really understand what it's like to have a high-level wrestler on top of you until you really grapple with one. It's so frustrating that everywhere you move, you don't have any space. You can't get that momentum.
Covered up extremely well there, Muhammad Ali, as Jake Butler threw in four punches in bunches. None of them connected.
I hear that Yuji Shimada's telling Jake, work to finish. Not a fan of the lay and pray. Jake's doing a good job of staying busy. He needs to kind of advance his position a little bit. And just get that knee out. You see, Ali's not really protecting guard. He can just slide that knee out and move right into mount. Just think he's so focused on ground and pound and just staying on those short chopping shots that he's not really thinking about passing his knee out.
It's those elbows and forearms that Jake's having more success with. There's another one. A lot of damage can be caused. I think I see a cut. I do indeed.
There is a cut over the eye. The little short elbows, they will definitely open up cuts.
Could be blood on
both sides. Oh, that was a solid elbow.
Wow. I think there's blood on both sides, perhaps both eyes there.
Well, Jake Butler has a ton of really high-level guys to train with. Leandro Ataides, it's a gash. I think that stopped being a cut 2 inches ago.
It is at least below the eye. This fight brought to you by AMC Live Group.
And Rich Franklin scoring the fight here, cage side with us. So far, Rich, how do you see the damage inflicted?
Well, Ali landed some great punches at the beginning of the round, but Butler was able to get him to the ground, controlled the round most of the fight, and inflicted some good damage at the end of that round there. So I have him ahead on the scorecards.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's a little bit more in the favor of Jake Butler. And a nice single leg attempt there from a little far out, but again, secures a takedown and moves right into cross-side.
Gripping the cage with his feet there, Ali, and he gets told off by Yuji Shimada. You can push away, you can walk along the cage, but you can't grip the cage, and that's why Yuji's giving his leg a slap.
You know, I talk about it all the time, and it gets a little redundant, I know, but wrestling is such a great base for mixed martial arts. And some of the guys like Randy Couture, Matt Hume, Matt Hughes, had a wrestling base, and that's what made them so successful in mixed martial arts, is having that. You're able to really dictate where the fight takes place, and your balance and coordination, it helps your jiu-jitsu tremendously, because those are things that, like, attributes that are really hard to teach. You know, Michael Jordan can sit there and show you how to play basketball like Michael Jordan, but you're not going to be Michael Jordan because his attributes are what make him Michael Jordan. It takes a long time to develop those. In wrestling, you have tremendous base and balance and pressure with your hips, like you see Jake Butler there. Even though Ali is popping all over the place, you know, Jake's not going anywhere. It's very difficult to get a high-level wrestler, especially a Division I wrestler, off of you. And this is using very little energy. This is a great economy of motion for Jake on top. He's starting to work that knee over. Might be looking for cross-side. I'm sorry, might be looking to move into mount.
Yes.
The way we score the 1FC fights here, a little different than everybody else. We score based on who came closest to finishing an actual fight. The most important thing we look for is who came closest to a submission or a near knockout. Second most important factor is the damage inflicted. Then things like striking superiority, ground control, takedowns and takedown defense, and lastly, aggression. So you're not going to see guys win a fight here solely because they got a couple of takedowns and stood on top of someone.
There's a lot of blood on Jake's arm, and that's obviously coming from Ali's eye, which we commented on about how nicely it had been patched up between rounds, but obviously that's opened again.
Yeah, you know, head cuts bleed a tremendous amount just because, you know, your heart's pumping hard to get the blood there, and you're laying on your back, and it just gets smeared everywhere. And that's not to say that that cut doesn't look like a river.
You often talk about how perspiration makes the body slippery and it makes it difficult to get purchase when we're trying to grapple there. But blood, that amount of blood makes it even worse.
For sure. I mean, you have to look at, you've got blood, you have sweat, you have Vaseline on your face. You know, if there's any, like, natural body oils or hair stuff that's coming off there, I mean, it's like being on a slip and slide of nasty stuff.
A slip and slide of nasty stuff. Does look a bit nasty there, I must say. Jake Butler using the elbow and the forearm to very good effect there, knowing that his opponent has incurred some damage to the face, and he'll be working on that. You take every advantage you can. If this fight can be stopped quickly for him, then that's what he'll want.
Well, I have to imagine that between rounds here in the next 30 seconds, the doctor's going to take a look, because Jake looks like he has a sunburned tan now from all the blood that's been all over his left shoulder and his back. But, you know, I bet you that cut's not nearly as big as you think it is. And you take a small cut and you rub it around on a wall, and it looks like there was a massacre happening.
Jake, work to finish.
Yeah, Yuji Shimada keeps telling Jake, work to finish. Jake needs to improve his position here and look to work into mount or start attacking submissions.
It's been a brutal time on his back there. Mohamed Ali taking comparatively clear face off Jake Butler is contrasted by the
inflicted or the ground control aspects of the fight.
Well, I think Jake has added to his lead in this fight. He spent the entire second round on top controlling Ali and then inflicted quite a bit of damage, as you can see by the blood that's on the cage and all over Jake in that round.
Yeah, absolutely. And in ground control, too, Jake just scored another takedown. How do you see it so far through going into the third?
All second round, he basically spent the entire time either in half guard or cross mount on Ali.
Yeah, I mean, he has just been dominating with that wrestling positioning. And now he's finally in mount, the most advantageous position we've seen him in. And Jake can see some urgency here.
We've seen him use elbows and forehands, but here come the hammer fists.
Those are crazy monkey punches.
Defends pretty well, actually, Ali, although some of them are getting through, but the combination of forearms and hands, and even upper arms as well there, and movement, good head movement from Ali. Really good defense there.
Ali's rolling with the punches, but now Jake's applying the don't move.
Yeah, I'll hold you with my right hand and punch you with my left.
Yeah, this is a bad spot for Ali to be in.
Yeah, and that's what made the difference. He grabbed hold of his chin, the man who'd beaten Sylvain Potard. And Potard is the only man to score a victory over Jake Butler in his professional career. So, fair bit of revenge there for the American, who fights out of Evolve MMA.